In this lesson, we're going to create a service control policy and apply it to our production account. Back in the console, the first thing I need to do is show you how to switch roles so that we're actually going to connect in to the production account. Now, I'm going to copy this account number. So I'm in organizations, I've expanded the root. Here we have the production OU and then the production account. And I just want to copy this account number to my clipboard. And here's a file which is in your course download in the organizations folder and it's called switchroles.txt. I'm just going to add this entry into here. So I now have account number and then the account number of my account that I want to switch into. And you'll find this file in code organizations switch roles. The role name is organization account access role. And I've got my display name for that account as DCT production. You can change that if you want. So make sure you've got your account number. We're going to need this to switch roles. So back in the console, up in the top right-hand corner here, click on this down arrow and choose switch roles. At the top here, we'll click on this button, switch role, paste in our account number, copy the name of our role, paste that in the middle here. Going to copy the name, the display name, and paste that in here. And then you can choose a color. Maybe I'm going to choose red for this one because it's a production account, so I want to be very careful with it. And that's ready. I can now switch role. So we're now logged into the DCT production account, and we've gained permissions assigned to the role that we just switched roles with. And that role has all permissions, so it has full permissions in this account. Now what I'm going to do is go over to IAM, and we're going to create a role. So let's go to roles. Create role. I'm going to choose the EC2 use case, click on next, and I want to add some permissions. So maybe I'll choose S3 and give it S3 read-only access. Let's click on next, go to review. I'll give it a name, deny role modification test, and create the role. So that worked. So clearly I have the permissions I need to do that. If I go into the role, I can then add additional permissions. So maybe I need DynamoDB full access. We'll attach that policy and that's no problem as well. So we definitely have the permissions we need to perform those operations. Now what I'm going to do is copy the ARN for the role. It's important to copy the role ARN, not the instance profile ARN. Now we have this code and what we're going to do is under resource, we're going to override this ARN, paste the ARN for our role in there. And now we have some JSON code for our service control policy. And what this code does is it's a deny policy that's going to deny access to any of these permissions on this specific resource. So in other words, we won't be able to attach a role policy. We won't be able to delete the role. We won't be able to put a role policy and so on. So we're going to have a lot of restrictions placed upon us for IAM permissions related to modifying this role. So let's copy this information to our clipboard. We'll come back and we're going to switch back to the management account. To do that, click on the down arrow and choose back to, and then whatever your username is from the management account. Back in the management account, I'm going to go over to AWS organizations. In organizations, let's click on policies on the left-hand side. You'll see that service control policies are disabled. So let's enable service control policies. Now you'll notice that the full AWS access policy exists. That's an AWS managed policy and it allows access to every operation. By default, organization uses what's called a deny list strategy. That means there's an SCP at the root which flows down to the entire organization, and that is an allow policy. You then add your deny list SCPs wherever you need to in the hierarchy. So if I click on the policy name, scroll down, you can see that the JSON is an allow for any action on any resource. And under targets, you'll see the organization, the organizational unit production, and both the management account as well as the production account. So let's go up a level to service control policies. We're going to create a policy. I'm going to scroll down to where the JSON is. Let's delete all of this code, paste our code in that includes our ARN. I'm going to give it a name. and then come down and create the policy. So the policy is created, but it's not attached anywhere yet. So let's go to AWS accounts. I'm going to choose my production OU, go to policies, and then on the right hand side here, click on attach. And I'm going to attach the deny access to a specific role policy I just created. We'll attach that policy, and those permissions will now be restricted for any account that's in this production OU. Back in IAM, I'm going to switch accounts again back to DCT production. And here's our role. So let's go and attach a policy to the role. Maybe now I need RDS permissions. So I'm going to choose RDS full access and click on attach. And this time it hasn't worked. It says you need permissions. Let's cancel out of there. Let's try and remove one of these policies. Again, it's not going to work. So the SCP has now restricted those permissions. Now, of course, I can create another role. So let's create another role and just test that it doesn't apply to a different role. I'll choose EC2, allow administrator access, and we'll create the role. I'm just going to give it the test SCP role name and just prove that I can create roles. So that works successfully. So really, it's just this specific role because that's the resource specified in the policy. For this specific role, we cannot modify any permissions, but we can create other roles because we do have IAM permissions. So that's all I wanted to show you in this lesson. We can go back up to the management account. And if I switch back to organizations, if you want to detach that policy, you would just go back to policies, choose the policy, and then detach. And that's no longer going to apply to that account. So you can now delete that role if you want to. Thank you.